So type 1 diabetes is a condition where the body immune system destroys or kills the cells which produce insulin. Insulin needs to be given either through injections, through insulin pumps, throughout the whole life. There is currently no cure.
It can be especially difficult managing blood glucose levels in very young children, and that's because they can't really communicate very effectively when their glucose levels are high or when they're low. They're very unpredictable in their behavior, so they won't tell you when they're about to run around and exercise, which can cause low or higher glucose levels. They won't always finish their meals, which is a time when we need to give insulin. And so because of that unpredictable nature, it's very, very difficult for parents and caregivers to decide how much insulin to give when.
Over the last 15 years, we've been working on the artificial pancreas project. And I'm thrilled that we've been able also to show how it works well in the very young children with type 1 diabetes. So the artificial pancreas comprises three things. There's a glucose sensor, which will be sitting on the skin. Then we have a computer program which is receiving the data from the cell sensor every 5 minutes. And when it's processing data, it will then tell an insulin pump how much insulin to give. And the communications through that is wireless as well.
It also relays text messages to my phone when I'm at work and Sophia's at school. So we can bolus and everything and boost and ease off literally all from the phone. We don't have to get the pump out to do anything. And it's so much easier if we're out and about going for dinner. I can, not that I would do it discreetly, but it's just so easy. I can just bolus her food and off she goes and eats her dinner.
So the closed loop therapy that we used in the study made a big difference to the children and the families on two different levels. One is that it improved glucose control in the very young children compared to the sensor augmented pump therapy that they used for the other half of the study, and which is currently standard therapy. And the other is that it really improved quality of life, both for the children and for their parents and caregivers. And that's because the closed loop system automatically adjusts insulin delivery based on what the child's glucose levels are. So if they're running high, it will give more insulin, and if they're running low, then it will give less insulin. And it does that without the parents having to do anything. So it really reduced burden for the families, whilst also improving glucose control.
Yeah, I've got my sleep back. I can not worry about Sophia being at school because it's also easy for the teachers to manage. And my mum as well knows a lot of what I know as well. So when she's with mum, I can relax knowing that she's okay.